should never belittle anyone's knowledge. You should never belittle anyone's status. The greatest men are the most humble men. Irrespective of how great they are, how great their status is, how close they are to Allah Almighty, they will always give importance to even those who on the apparent may not have the same status. Sayyidina Awais ibn Amir al-Qarni, he was a great man of Allah who lived in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He lived during the lifetime of Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam. He was from Yemen, from a town called Qarn, and he traveled from Yemen to Medina Munawwara to meet the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In one narration, it is said that when he arrived there, Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam were out of Medina Munawwara, they were out of the city, and he didn't have the opportunity to meet. His mother wasn't well, so he had to go back home. So he had to go back and take care of his mother. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam was told that this great man has come from Yemen. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam told the companions. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam told Sayyidina Umar and Sayyidina Ali that there is a man within my ummah. Allah has given him such a maqam that on the day of judgment, he will forgive that many number of people equal to the number of sheep that the Banu Kalb have. If you meet him, give my salam to him and ask him to make dua a maghfirat for my ummah. That, oh Allah, forgive my ummah, please. Well, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling this great companion, Sayyidina Umar bin al-Khattab, that ask him to make dua. It doesn't matter about maqam. Maybe Allah has given him such a maqam. And then it was the time of Hajj during the caliphate of Sayyidina Umar. So Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu went, and he radiallahu anhu asked all the people, where are the people of Yemen? He said, they are in that corner there. When he arrived there, he said, are you the people of Yemen? He said, yes. Said, where are the people of Qarn? Said, there's a group of them that have come from this town Qarn. They're sat over there. And he asked them a question. He said, where's Awais ibn Amir? They said, he's an old man. He came to do his Hajj. Very frail now. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said that when you see him, a mark that who Awais al-Qarni is, that he'll have a mark on his hand. There'll be a spot on his hand that you will recognize him. You'll notice who he is. So Sayyidina Umar bin al-Khattab said, take me to him. They found that Awais al-Qarni was praying at that time. When he finished his prayer, Sayyidina Umar said, are you Awais ibn Amir al-Qarni? Show me your hand. The signs the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned, white hair, etc. Said, yes, I am Awais ibn Amir. Said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told me to give you salam from him. How great is the maqam of Awais al-Qarni? Give salam to Awais al-Qarni from me, and he asked me to ask you to make dua for the ummah. Like, it's such a great maqam. Sayyidina Umar, Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, yet irrespective of how great their status, their position is, they went to someone who was in lesser status to them on the apparent and said, go and seek dua. That's a true man of Allah. A true man of Allah will never put another man down. A true man of Allah will never judge another man. He will never think of himself superior.